Hello and welcome to this video tutorial on WallaceiX, following on from the previous video in this tutorial series, in which we looked at tab 3 of the WallaceiX user interface that predominantly focused on selection and analysis for selection purposes. And we looked at the different selection methods and how we can add specific solutions from the population to the export list. What we'll look at in today's tutorial is how we can extract the phenotypes or the geometry behind these specific solutions. Now, if you may remember from the previous video tutorials, or the first video tutorial that I did about this design problem where I was connecting the genes and the objectives to the components, I elected to not connect the phenotype. Not only that, but to disable the components generating my phenotype. And that was because these components were not contributing in any way to the calculation of my fitness objectives. So if I were to enable them now, keep in mind that we've already run the simulation, so whatever I'm doing right now is not actually affecting the simulation results. I can now connect the phenotype, which, if you also may remember, is comprised from a BREP and a mesh. So I simply meshed the BREPs. And so what I have here is, for this solution, 180 BREPs and 180 meshes in two different branches. So if I were to now connect this phenotype into the Wallacei component, I can open Wallacei and I can export these solutions here. So what I'll do is I'll simply click export, and I'm going to get this dialog box. It's telling me that I'm going to export 16 solutions, and the estimated time is about 10 seconds. Now, this is only an estimated time. This is not a very accurate time, so please use this for indicative purposes only. If I click OK, what's happening now is that the simulation is reinstating each one of these solutions and saving the outputted phenotype. Once that's done, I'm going to get another dialog box informing that the export process has finished, and I can go back into my Rhino interface. So what I have right now from this output here is all of the solutions, or all the phenotypes associated with that solution. So the path number is actually corresponding to the generation and individual number of that solution. And the way it outputs them is it outputs them into a data type that we've created called Wallacei phenotype. Now, to decode this Wallacei phenotype and extract the geometry and the meshes, I'll go to my Wallacei tab and I'll go under Wallacei decode phenotype. Now, the decode phenotype component is by default preview off and by default toggle false. Now, this is a double safety mechanism that we've introduced to encourage you to be careful of how you preview this geometry. So for Grasshopper to preview this this geometry, which is comprised from 180 BREPs and 180 meshes, is relatively straightforward. It's relatively light, and according to your computer setup, you shouldn't have any problems with displaying this number of geometry. But if you were to display the geometries associated with your Wallacei phenotype, this might be considerably slower, and it might crash Rhino. So if I were to turn this Boolean on, so right now I have no geometries, this decoding process is instantaneous. However, what it's now outputting for me is that for each solution, the geometries, which is either BREPs, curves, or points, and it's distinguishing between the geometry and the meshes that I inputted into the phenotype input. And so I have the meshes as a different stream. This is beneficial if I wanted to use meshes for specific purposes and geometries for other purposes. What I can do, obviously, is I can go to, just to quickly visualize this, so if I just explode tree, match outputs. And so these are all the geometry. Because it's a mesh, it's a little bit easier to visualize. It's not as heavy. And I can just very quickly go through them and so on and so forth. Now, I can always go back into my Wallacei phenotype, Wallacei components. I can clear the list. And let's say if I wanted to output the last generation. So for example, generation 99. So I'll add it to my export list. and I will click export. So it tells me that it's going to export 20 solutions and it's going to take also approximately 10 seconds. So if I click OK, right now it's instating each solution in the generation in the background. What it's doing is it's also minimizing Rhino when it's conducting this export process to maximize efficiency. The export has been completed. If I go back into Rhino, what this does is that it overrides the phenotypes from the previous export. So if you wanted to store the phenotypes from the previous export, what I recommend is that for you to store, you know, the data, internalize it, and so on. So you'll notice that's how a little bit slower it was to display the B-reps than it is for the meshes. And of course, internalizing might be a little bit slower as well. So once you internalize, then the data is saved into the Grasshopper file, and that's what's going to make the Grasshopper file quite heavy. So this is the geometry for the 99th generation from solution 0 to solution 19. And these are the associated B-reps for that geometry. So this is one of the most powerful features of Wallacei, and we really hope that you take full advantage of it, mainly because it allows you to analyze your results and extract specific solutions rather than having to extract the entire population or be limited to a specific generation, let's say the last generation only. Now you can extract any generation, any solution, according to any analytic method that you choose. So that's it for this video tutorial. The next video tutorial will look into the different outputs from the Wallacei component, the fitness values, the genomes, and the data, and how we can use these and correspond them with the phenotypes. Thank you for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.